Thank you. My name is Bayuni Shantiko, and this paper is based on our work with also my colleague here, Bayuni Shantiko. Today we will discuss about challenge and lesson learned in engaging multiple stakeholders in improving land use decision in Indonesia, particularly in to our site in Kaposuru district and in Central Serang district. So as my colleague has already discussed about the multiple layers of governance, there are different set of rules decided in central level, government, provincial level, and district level. There are also a different set of rules even within the community itself. So this set, different set of rules, formal, informal level, decentralized or centralized type of decision maker, has created a high uncertainty for future income performance in developing countries, especially in Indonesia. Then there is also the need for the publics and decision makers to be informed on what could be happen in the future. So using this information, they can do something about it, and then to make changes for their make improvement. So the question that we ask for this, what process can allow multiple needs of land taken into account in the just decisions process? So by asking this question, and we try to answer these questions by using a method called participatory prospective analysis. And this is an applied foresight method developed by our colleagues in CIRAT. So this method is basically engaging all stakeholders. It is participatory, and also we within this method we use expert meeting groups where we call stakeholders together and to discuss on particular subjects. Having said that, we also have research on background studies on biophysic, socioeconomic studies. So then after a series of workshops, we disseminate the result, and also coming with agreed scenarios and visions, and also coming up then to implementation and monitoring and evaluation. So who is the stakeholders that we've been engaged to? The local stakeholders, mostly the government officials, and also local parliament, national park, private sectors, and communities, customer leaders, farmers, fishermen, and university and NGOs. And due to this, we are using expert meeting groups method. We limit the stakeholders about 50 and to 20 stakeholders, so we can manage the discussion and more effectively. So we follow this 8-step of PPA process. First, we try to decide together within the groups what kind of system that we are going to discuss in this process, and then to follow up with identifying variables and definition of the variables, to analyze all the variables, and also then developing stakeholders, and also coming up to the implication of the scenario, which is we come up to the action plan after the scenarios. So the system boundary that we mean in this process is the question that we want to discuss during the meeting with the stakeholders. So the question that the stakeholders that agree to discuss is what could be the future of land use in this particular district, Kaposulu, and also in Central Serang. So we all, they also agree that they will limit the, or they will make the boundary of the time that this future of land use will be about 20 years ahead, and then also the decided the geographic boundary between within the district itself. So after decided the question that what could be the future of land use, then they define a variable. So the variable in this context is the variable that affecting the future of the land use in each district within the 20 years. So we come up with a set of variables. So each of the stakeholders then think about what kind of variable affecting the future. So it can be categorized as an economic variable, social politics, and environmental. For example, that there is variable like customary law, education, income. And for the whole set of variables, we do analysis, mutual analysis. So the main frame of the main features of this method is how the stakeholders together within the groups makes analysis for this each of variable, because we then come up with a long list of variables, and every stakeholders think that each of variable they thought is important, so we want to know which one is the variable has the strongest influence among others. So what they do basically is to find the direct relationship or direct influence one variables to another variables, and also indirect influence which calculated in the software. So in this method, we also equipped with software, which is here I illustrated how they calculated the indirect influence. For the direct influence, is if there is a influence directly, then they put score 1, and then if there is no influence, they put score 0. So this one is the picture of the showing that this is the Excel spreadsheet where we use for this methodology. That for example, this chart has direct influence to coordinations, for example, so they put one, for example. So this is the influence dependence matrix. Then from this series of analysis, putting direct influence analysis, then we come up with the graph illustrating that the key driver usually located in the high influence axis and also high dependence axis. So the more variable influence the other, then the more they will located in this area, the top area, and the more variables are affecting by other variables, then the more they dependent variables. So the idea is for the key variable, if the key variables have more influence, then if we want to have interventions to particular variable who has strong influence, for example in here, then it is more likely to have a bigger impact than variables in this part, for example in the marginal part. So the key variables that are coming up from this process, having had we already analyzed the variable, is here. It is the example of the variables resulted from the Kapuasulu case. So what we do then with this key variable to build our scenario, then we first this one is the key variables, then we need to discuss together with the stakeholders what kind of the state of the key variables might be happen in the future. So then for one variables, they can have like two states of key variables. For example, in government policy, it is the state variables that can be happen in the future is policy are drawn together with the favor in with the communities, and also other state variable, which is the contrast one, is the policy that favor for the groups in and certain interest. So these variables are has to be contrast to each other, so then we can use this combination for each of the state variables to make a scenario. So this one, how to make a scenario. So as I can tell you that during the process of making scenario, we not coming up only with this four scenario, but we end up with maybe about 10 different scenario. But then we try to compiled together, so to join together, so we then come up with the strongest or the most scenario. So scenario that we develop during the process is still narrative, still in text. So we try to put this textual in more pictures. So when we disseminate this information of scenario, we can have a better people can have a better inform and also a better understanding. So after having all the scenario, we need to disseminate this scenario to the stakeholders who didn't attend the meeting. And from this scenario, we try to to ask the people, which scenario do you think that it is preferable for you, or it is desirable for you to be achieved in the future, and which one is the least desirable, which is undesirable, happens in the future. So from this scenario, I will show you this comparative two distinct scenario. Which the one is the scenario that is desirable, which is to say that all coordinations, all educations are improved, people are mastering technology, or and language planning are considered as a collaboration between all the groups. But on the other scenario, there is a contrast between people are fighting each other because of lack of customary law, and also people are also quarreling about the land. So from this different scenario, then we ask people to think about what kind of action can be done to achieve either desirable scenario and to anticipate on undesirable scenario. Okay, the challenge that we been gone through from this methodology is who will pay the participation cost, meaning that this is the process that engagement that initiated by the donor assistant project. But then if the project ended, so what happened with this process, and then realizing that the cost of getting people together, engaging all stakeholders, a series of workshop, also time boundary that they already have, and how could be this methodology or this process can be implemented for future monitoring and implementation. And the second is because of this process is not institutionalized in the current government system, the government has their own planning system, which is more on top-down planning process, and also as Bunga mentioned about the consultancy process, consultant, which is more likely to be a socialization process. So this process could be added to the current government system, but the question is how to do or how to include this into the system. So, and then the third one is about the idealistic and realistic scenario. We found that there is a tendency that people often go through the scenario that are idealistic, and then we know that sometimes this even not possible in the real world. So this is also we maybe some of you has experience in the scenario building process, then it could be also help us to get some feedback on this. So the conclusion for this process is with the PPA process has proven successfully bringing different together in on the table, and then they start to understand about their environments in different perspective. One of the government officials said they never been exposed in such method before, and then he kind of happy to do this method. And then, and even one of the tourism head agency, he wants to apply this method in this agency. And also using PPA and scenario with different stakeholders, also raising their awareness on working together to collaborate and make further actions, because the having all the scenario, then they can develop action plan to how to realize it within a time span of 20 years. So thank you very much.